Real quick for this important message brought to you by me. What's up, y'all? It's your boy Damone, and y'all already know what time it is. We've been waiting for this magical, mystical moment. Lidica is here, so we're just gonna go ahead and start this. You know what I'm saying? Watch a little short video. You know, you guys can kind of see this as always. You guys know I'm gonna talk about the hero in a separate instance outside of this video, just because, like in this video, I just really wanted to cover the general, you know, patch notes and things that are happening, things that I think that how the game, I think, overall is going to be affected because of the changes. So with that being said, you know, hold on, wait for it. Yeah, let's go. Jump shot. All right. So let's go and scroll down. As you guys know, Lidica's new. New artifact is going to be coming with Lidica. Let me just tell you right out the gate, this is basically Dust Devil for Hunters. Okay, so if you guys can see, this is a chance to attack with a basic attack. If the target survives the single attack, can only be activated once per turn. This is going to be ridiculous on any hunter, specifically Shuri, any hunter that has some kind of effect that helps your life out. Okay, so I don't see this being good on like Assyria. I mean, it could be, but I feel like there's just better things to use on Assyria, better things to use on like a Yuna, right? But units like Shuri, oh my god, right? Oh my god, right? Or units with a first skill that's very, very valuable overall to the team, either with a push or a pull mechanic or anything else for that matter, okay? So that's something that you guys are going to look at. Drop rate up. Lidica is going to be available starting 220, 236. Okay, so we got 2 weeks for this one. And then what I think is going to happen next week is, you know, because we got the light essences, it'll probably be like a 3 or 4-star unit that's going to be included in the banner. But we'll just have to wait and see. I could be wrong, but, you know, who knows? All right, so special side story, week 2. You guys definitely want to pay attention to this, mainly just because this card right here, the Sword of Judgment, is going to also increase the currency that you drop, that you get as a drop, okay? There's a small little diagram that they explain in here. You get some bonuses and stuff. New resources this week will be getting the secret letter. So the secret letter, make sure you pay attention. I'll wait a second to talk about that. But the artifact itself, the new 5-star artifact, increases the amount of letters that you get. Does not affect the other resource currency, the resource from last week, but it does affect the letters that you get. So this is the week that you definitely can take advantage, because depending on how many cards you pull while summoning and how high you level the card will determine how many letters you or what bonus you get with your 5-star artifact, up to 70%, bro. 70. Okay, let's go. So this is huge, guys. Oop, I just dropped my credit card. Uh-oh. Complete the hidden achievements in order to receive your special reward. I want you guys to look at this and just take this in. Just take it in. Because right now you got an epic helmet, this Rose Coronet, that is really, really good. The Rose Coronet can literally go on any support depending on how it rolls. And this is very, very important. I need you guys to hear what I'm saying. I know you guys are not really hearing what I'm saying because you guys are too busy looking at this crit damage necklace. But I need you guys to hear what I'm saying about this Rose Coronet. This Rose Coronet, depending on how it rolls, can go anywhere. If it rolls a lot of attack percent, this is going to be your Hazel necklace, okay? If it rolls a lot of health and defense, it's going to be pretty much any other support, okay? If it rolls speed, defense, or health combo, whatever the speed is, the optional, because depending, like, if it just rolls all speed and attack, again, Hazel. But like I said, if it's like health, defense, speed, then it's most likely going to go on units like Angelica, you know, Angelica or stuff like that, or like DN, you know, pretty much other support units that are primarily going to be healing, Akati, stuff like that. But again, if it's a primarily, like if you get like triple attack rolls or some crazy like that, then this definitely is a Hazel or Aether piece of gear. Okay, keep that in mind, Hazel or Aether, or any other attack scaling healer. Now, this lucky amulet, according to Akati's, these are cross-shaped accessories that symbolize the Church of the Goddess and bring good luck. Good luck is right, because if you look at this crit damage necklace here, 71 gear, it's really, really, really good, with crit damage 11%, with health, attack, crit chance, and effectiveness. If you guys are looking at this piece of gear, depending on how this rolls will determine where it's going to go. So if you can, if you're maxing out crit chance, I mean, crit chance you want regardless, okay? Regardless of whoever you're putting this on. But if it rolls mostly health, then ideally it's going to be going on a unit like a Ken or a HP type bruiser, okay? If it rolls mostly attack, and crit, then now you're edging more towards the damage dealer style, right? So that's kind of what we're looking at there. So you guys definitely want to pay attention to that overall, just to make sure that, you know, when you're looking at the gear, that you're getting the best bang for your buck in terms of, you know, overall potential in terms of, like, these necklaces and stuff. So make sure you guys pay attention to that. I should probably full screen this now since we're not streaming, okay? That way you guys can see it better. So that's going to be the big thing there. Either way, though, even if it rolls like crazy health or crazy effectiveness, this is still a good necklace to have pretty much on any unit that you need to deal damage. Okay? Same thing with the support thing, but I wanted to give you guys some general guidelines that you can work towards in order to get the biggest bang for your buck. Again, at the end of the day, you're grown. I can't tell you what to do with your thing. Just, you know, make sure you get the best bang for your buck when using those pieces of gear. Additional effect currency, the secret letter. This just breaks down what's going on here. Love potion helps you get 50% bonus for both. You know, if you guys are farming, and then of course the sword of judgment is specifically for the letters. Okay, I don't know how it's going to affect next week's event, so we'll just have to wait and see the stat breakdown next week. But yeah. You know, you guys can go ahead and just, you know, check that out and see. Now, I don't know if these stack, though, by the way. If it stacks, put it in the comment box. You know, if you guys notice that they stack later on, put this in the comment box and, you know, it'll help people out. Okay, so epilogue stage added. The chapter epilogue luxury shop district has been added to June, up to June 3rd. Okay, this stage can be entered by clearing Bologna's hidden achievement. And this stage may be cleared only once during the event. Now, other improvements and bug fixes, they had some miscellaneous stuff, some bugs, and a little arena stuff that they fixed. As you guys know, the items will be coming out of the shop. I do want to talk about this. Timer displaying the next shop list has been added to the Power of Knowledge shop, so you guys know. The shop list will refresh at 1800 UTC on Wednesdays across all servers, okay? Next shop list refresh is going to be on February 27th. So, listen. That's when we get the next refresh. So when you guys know, that's just what it is. And then they'll let us know when the next one after that is going to be. Okay, so it'll be next week. So you guys take care of what you guys got to take care of. With the end of Arena Season 1, the Unknown Slate, Gladiator's Axe, Gladiator's Armor, Helm, and Token will be removed from the Conquest Point shop. But this is important, and this is where I failed. Unknown Slate will return to the Conquest Point shop when Season 2 begins. Players who bought this item in Season 1 will be able to purchase it again once it returns. So, like, for myself, I was like, yeah, whatever, I ain't gonna buy it, you know, it's one time per account, so, you know, as it'll probably be there. That's like that was my mentality, but now seeing that I literally missed a free imprint, I'll make sure not to make that mistake again, and I'll be doing Arena again, and I'll be buying that Unknown Slate immediately right out the gate. I'm really curious to see if they're gonna add gear, if they add gear, and to see what set it is, and we'll do a whole separate video on that tomorrow when that drops. Okay, so also there's some quality of life stuff here, some UI improvements. Looks like there's some issues here that they changed. Chaos Sect actually jump animation has been adjusted to look more normal. This is important. Mascot Hazel now uses Urgent Regen slightly more often, so they changed her priority, so she focuses that skill more. Also, when Mascot Hazel uses a girl in uniform, existing increases attack greater buffs are no longer removed. Okay, so she had a little bug in there. So, boom, there you go. Okay, when an auto battle is active, Rose will now use her skill Shield with Light, even if allies have debuffs applied. Okay, so a nice little minor thing here. They changed some descriptions. Now, the big thing here that I really wanted to really talk about here, when you look at this, at the start of battle, combat readiness variation that can be gained according to the speed of the character has been reduced from 10% to 5. So basically what had happened before, it was like a plus 10, minus 10 system, where like if you had like a, let's say you had a 100 speed unit, sometimes it could be 110 or sometimes it could be 90. Right? Depending on how, you know, RNG was rolling, and it made a dramatic difference in, you know, what was going on with the flow of combat. After tomorrow's patch, it's going to be reduced to 5%. So it's less of a margin. So you're basically playing with plus 5 or minus 5% to ensure that your units are going to go A, in the at the right time, and B, in the correct order. So make sure you guys pay attention to that. Sometimes you guys are wondering, like, yo, how come, you know, this unit is blah, 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 and it's not going first? That was the reason why. And they've addressed this issue. So I feel like this is going to be a huge quality of life shift. So for those of you guys who had struggled with that before, maybe in, like, Guild Wars with like Arena, this is going to be a big deal. Okay, so that's going to be a cool thing here. Outside of that, guys, I mean, it's just some minor stuff. Not really minor. Another big thing they did was achievements for Wyvern, Golem, Banshee has been added. So for 11, I don't know what the rewards are. We're just going to wait and see what those are tomorrow. But everything else is pretty much kind of minor, you know, like they're just adding some UI stuff, some quality of life stuff here and there. No energy changes yet, unfortunately, but this is the gist of everything that's changed this week. Overall, I'm totally excited. I literally cannot wait till this next video where I get to talk about Lidica. But I wanted to take a little bit of time and talk about these patch notes and share those with you guys, because you know it's update time just like every week, every Tuesday or Wednesday morning. You know, we get on these. Apologies, a little late, streamed a little bit later than usual. And yeah, with that being said, thank you guys so much for tuning in. As always, it's your boy Damone. Let me know what you guys think about this patch in the comment box below. Talk to your fellow peers, you know, start a conversation, you know, see what they think. If you guys don't like about it, dance battle. Anyway, I'll catch you guys in the next video. Love y'all. Take care. We'll see y'all later. Peace.